Hi YouTube friends and welcome to the Vibe Tribe. Today I'm super excited about this video. We're making chocolate! Who doesn't love chocolate, right? So I put a lot of work into these. I super love chocolate, so I wanted these to be amazing and they turned out amazing. I have a lot of chocolate in my freezer right now. So first step, let's just turn this on, let it warm up for a second, and I'm gonna show you guys what we need. So we need half a cup of Rice Krispies. We need 1 cup of milk chocolate chips. We need 1 cup of the light colored cocoa, 5 tablespoons of maple syrup, and then we're gonna need 3 tablespoons of peanut butter. You could put whatever kind you want, smooth or crunchy, doesn't matter. 1 cup of crushed almonds. And to make the crushed almonds, you just put these in a Ziploc bag and you just hit them with the back of a spoon repeatedly until they're this size. And then we also need our cannabis infused coconut oil. So we're gonna be using 1/2 cup of the cannabis infused coconut oil and then 1/2 cup of non-infused oil, so just regular oil. Okay, so first step, let's get our oil. Okay, so this is a measured out cup already. You can tell that this is the weed stuff because it's beautiful and green, lovely. I know it's a little bit more than 1/2 cup, but whatever. You can put more if you want, less if you want. Okay, so just put that right in there. Okay, and then we are going to put another 1/2 cup of this uninfused oil, which you might want to use a different spoon. I'll use this one. So with this recipe, you want to pay a lot of attention to it. It doesn't take long to make. It's probably the fastest recipe I've ever made. So once it gets started, you don't want to leave. You want to get it done. You don't want to walk away or else you're going to end up ruining it. So you have to let the oil melt before we can put any more ingredients in. Ooh. So we'll just leave that for a second. We'll let it melt. Okay, so now that our oil is all melted, we don't want it to boil. We are just warming this up. You can turn your oven down just a little bit. Like I said, you don't want it to boil. So now that that is melted, we are going to put our cocoa in. And you're gonna want to put it in this order because if you don't, the maple syrup doesn't sit right. So the 1 cup of cocoa powder, we're just gonna mix that in. Okay, and then we're gonna put our chocolate chips in, and this is 1 cup. I'm gonna let those melt. So I ate 2 of these yesterday, and like, these are amazing, so good. Even with the taste of the marijuana oil, it just is amazing. I don't know what it is, but try not to eat too many of them, because I couldn't even get off the couch yesterday. It was pretty funny. Okay, and then we are going to put our 1 cup of almonds. And then this is our lecithin, sorry. It's gonna help just bind everything together. So the marijuana oil, the peanut butter, everything interacts together better. Sorry, I can't say that. It has a lot of health benefits too, which is really great. Okay, and then we're going to put 5 tablespoons of the maple syrup. So you can actually get egg lecithin, you can get sunflower and soya. I'd recommend getting sunflower. It is processed in a more gentle way and it's just better for you than the soy and the egg. OK, Okay, so now we're gonna be putting in the Rice Krispies. That's half a cup. And if you like the Rice Krispies in the Easter Bunnies, that is exactly what this is gonna taste like. So three of these peanut butter. I wanted to make sure this isn't the spoon I use for the marijuana. Although you can infuse peanut butter with cannabis, so that's probably not a bad thing anyway. I love my peanut butter. Okay, and we're gonna wanna blend this. I'm very proud of this recipe. I know I've said that already, but I really want my friends at the Vibe Tribe to try this out. It is incredible. Okay, so that is nice and melted. You can see that all the chocolate chips are melted. Everything's blended very well together. And that's really it. That's as simple as it is. Oh, wait. No, it's not. The vanilla. Almost forgot the vanilla. That makes a big difference. We don't want to forget the vanilla. So we're going to put half a teaspoon of vanilla. Let's mix that again. There, now it is done. And then we're just going to bring it over to our molds. I really like this size. I prefer these molds, but I like to work with what I have. I don't really like to go out and buy things just because I want them. So I'm gonna use these. The stars I don't find are very good because of the almonds. So when you are going out to buy your molds for the chocolate, I would get bigger ones like these ones or these ones. I wouldn't get them with sharp edges like the stars. And you don't want them too big either because like this one, I can't eat a full one of those or I would be like wheelchair bound, like would not work out. Okay, so we're just gonna take our tablespoon and we're just gonna pour the chocolate into the mold. Just like that. It makes a little bit of a mess, but it is totally worth it. And you get quite a few chocolates out of this as well. It's quite impressive. And my friends with children, please, please put these somewhere that your kids do not eat them. Getting a nice green container and saying mom's or dad's stuff would work just great. Or if you have teenagers, maybe a lock and key too, because they might just try to eat them. There's lots of benefits to these as well. You have your almonds, you have your coconut oil, you have your cocoa. So they're actually pretty good for you. Or maybe I'm just telling myself that because I want them to be, who knows. I do love chocolate. So I was hoping I didn't have to use the stars, but I'm gonna have to. They only break off a little bit if you use the stars or anything sharp and pointy, like also some of the crowns. Just breaks them off a little bit, but maybe you'll have a different mold tray than mine. So that is it, my friends. We put these in the fridge for about 45 minutes to an hour, and then you just pop them out and they're done. So we'll be back in an hour. Okay, my friends, it's been 45 minutes. For the bigger molds, I would for sure do an hour. So this is what they kind of turn out like. And then like so easy to pop out. So you just go, boop. And then there's your little chocolate like that. That easy. And of course, if you're gonna give these to somebody, you know, you can clean them up, cut them around a little bit. I think they wouldn't care if there was more on there. I know I wouldn't. And that's it. So I hope you guys try these out because they are fantastic. I'd love to hear your comments about them if you tried them, how you thought they tasted. I know you'll just love them though. It's just so good. So remember, you're never too high to subscribe to the Vibe Drive. So peace, my friends.